Hi, I'm Max the Menace, PowerPoint animator, and in this tutorial, I'll teach you how to animate in PowerPoint. Once you know how to make animations in PowerPoint, you can use them for school projects like this. The motion we're going to be animating today is called the pelvic thrust. There are two ways you can animate it. One is with your own memory, and the other is by shooting reference. You will shoot reference as it's a faster and easier way of creating animation. Let's get started, shall we? The first thing that you want to do is to stand in an open room, making yourself perpendicular to the camera for the best angle. Then, record yourself doing the naughty motion. After that, screenshot each individual frame of the recording to turn it into a picture. You now have reference images for your pelvic thrust. Now, here comes the fun part of animating in PowerPoint. So, let's slide in! Before we input our photos, we need a rig. So I'll create a simple stickman rig using shapes. It will have all the joints to what a human has, such as shoulders, hips, and everything else you can think of. Once you made your rig and want to input a reference photo into a slide, go to Insert Picture and select Browse on Device. And find your reference photo for it. You now need to repeat this for many slides in the file, or I'll be referring to from now on as frames. Now, move and rotate the rig parts until it matches with the reference you shot. This will take some time, so I'll be back once I pose the rig to all the frames. Now you have all the frames done and it's time to remove the reference images. Going through the frames one by one can make you clearly see that it's moving the right way. Make any change to the background if you'd like. Now we must export the frames as PNGs. Go to the File tab in the upper left, then click Export and choose the PNG format. A message will pop up saying if you want to export just this one or all of it. Choose the All of It option and wait for the files to be exported. They will all be found in a folder located in the destination folder you chosen. Now, take these frames into your editing software and put them simultaneously close to each other, each exposed for a little less than a tenth of a second. Export the video, and you finally have a PowerPoint animation of your pelvic thrust animation. This is really naughty. You can now use the video and speed it up or down till it syncs to the beat of a song, or you can leave it inaudible. After some final editing, I present to you the PowerPoint pelvic thrust animation. Once you are more experienced and become the goddess of PowerPoint, you can animate things that seem like they were made in an animation software. Thank you for watching the tutorial, and as always,